My name is Cindy Romero. I'm the music teacher here at St. James Episcopal School, and I have directed this camp. We've had a lot of fun doing it. The kids have, in just 10 short days, very short days, put together a really fun musical telling the story of Jack and the Beanstalk. And you can hear they're very excited back there to tell their stories. I'm not going to take a lot of time other than to say thank you so much for bringing them every day. I hope you make this part of your yearly tradition, because this has definitely been a really fun camp and worthwhile to tell a story like this. And you're going to find that the kids have not only used music, they've also used rhyme. They put together their own signs and their own stock, Jack and the Beanstalk. They worked really hard. So it's been worthwhile. So I hope you make this an annual tradition, because it's definitely been a lot of fun. Okay, so without any further ado, Jack and the Beanstalk.
Off you go to market, don't delay. Jack, 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 J For once, dear, but deep in me, there's something that's wrong with our tree. I saw him on my gizzard throws a giant with a clever nose. A clever nose, I get the gist. You must be going round with twists. I swear it, Mum. He smelled me out. He said he smelled an angel. You brains, boy, and well, he might. I told you every single night to take a bath because you smell. But would you drip? Would you yell? You even make your mother shrink because of your unholy spit. This is my answer to this. If you're so clean, why don't you climb the crazy moon? Gadzooks, I say. By gad, I will. There's life within the earth still.
Skirt of the journey.
Oh no!
Now, what did this giant smell his mom Jack listen for the queen?
He gazed aloft, he wondered when the dreaded words would come. Then, from somewhere high above the ground,
there came a frightful crunching sound.
He heard the giant mutter twice.
By gosh, that tasted very nice.
Although he said in grumpy tones,
I wish there weren't so many bones.
By Christopher, by gosh, by gosh, the giant's eaten up my mom. She smelled her out. She's in his belly. I had a hunch that she was smart.
Jack stood there gazing longly across huge and golden trees.
Golly gosh,
I guess I'll have to take a watch. But I'm going to get up this tree without the giant smelling me, and that's my only hope.
He rushed indoors and grabbed the soap.
Thank you.
okay if you want to take your kids with you now. If you wouldn't mind just letting me know so I know that everybody's accounted for. But thank you so much.